I think it's difficult to preserve something that you don't understand, that you can't really get a good handle on how it functions. A lot of these systems, unfortunately, are seeing declines in health over the past couple of years. And really what we are trying to do is get a solid handle on how these systems are interconnected, what makes them function properly. You really can't preserve something effectively if you don't understand how it's going to change.
One of the important things about MarineGEO is we're not only trying to document that change, we're also trying to really understand the patterns and the processes that are driving that change.
MarineGEO is interested in taking a pulse on the life of the world's oceans.
You see lots of projects start up in different areas, and they're usually around for a few years. It's the rare project that starts up and intensively studies an area for 5, 10, 15, 20 years. That's what's special about Carrie Bow. It's been used as a research station since the 70s, and it's still going to this day.
So Carrie Bow Cay is a special place. It's home for a small group of scientists for a week or more at a time.
It sits 14 miles off the coast of Belize, and it essentially sits right on top of the Mesoamerican Barrier Reef.
Last year was kind of our first Carrie Bow campaign. So this year we're back.
We're collecting fish data, coral recruitment data. This year, for the first time, we're doing habitat mapping on a larger scale.
We're looking at coral reefs, mangroves, and seagrass.
All these ecosystems are intimately connected to one another, and they rely on one another for their health and stability.
Seagrasses are the lifeblood of a lot of coastal environments. Unfortunately, seagrasses are declining at a global rate of about 7% per year. My goal as a biologist with the Smithsonian and part of the MarineGEO campaign is to help establish their seagrass monitoring research. Part of our research involves conducting surveys, and we can also actually get a lot of information about the environment from looking at the chemistry in the seagrass tissue itself.
On this field campaign for MarineGEO at Carrie Bow Cay, I would say I have several objectives. Conduct the ongoing long-term research, to scout sites for future research, and also to initiate a new experiment.
Another goal of this campaign is to deploy process assays. So for this, we've made what we call squid pops and weed pops. This is important because it allows us to compare cross habitat types and see how fish consumption varies from place to place around Carrie Bow. The information that MarineGEO gives us will allow us to ask more detailed and pointed questions in the future about these different types of habitats.
And we already know from the way that we're looking back at data from several decades ago that the data we're collecting now will be used to answer questions that we can't even anticipate.
Human population is growing, and there are increasing number of stressors and impacts to a lot of these coastal areas. And so what MarineGEO wants to do is really understand what is happening, how our systems are changing, and what we could possibly do to prevent or mitigate that change.